class, we learned the characteristics of particles of matter. Today, we will learn about states of matter. You know, children, when we look at our surroundings, we see a different types of material. It means that we have different states of matter also. The matter is broadly classified into three types. One is solids, liquids, and gases. Isn't it, children? Matter is classified into mainly three types. One is solids, second liquids, and the third is what? Gases. And still two more states we have. You don't worry about those two. I will give a small brief introduction about those two, which are not there in our syllabus. That is plasma, which is called as a fourth state of matter, and fifth state, one more, that is BEC, Bose-Einstein condensate we call, isn't it? Don't worry about those two now, only discuss about or learn about the three states of matter. What are those, children? Solids, liquids, and gases. First, we will come with the solids. You know, children, solids have definite shape, means they have one particular shape. Isn't it? They have distinct boundaries and even they have a fixed volumes. But they are compressible in a very negligible. Solids are compressible into very least, means very small amount. And solids may break under the action of a force, but it is very difficult to regain that shape. Isn't it? Solids may break under the action of a force. Okay, children. Solids may break under the action of force, but it is very difficult to regain its shape. Because of that reason, solids are called as a rigid. Isn't it? What is the meaning of rigid here? It's very difficult to regain its shape. For example, I'll give. That is, let us take a sugar or salt. The each individual crystals of sugar or salt remains fixed, means they are not going to change even if you take it in your hand or if you keep in a jar. Means the shape of the crystals of sugar or salt remains fixed, isn't it? Okay, now what we concluded at the second point, the solids are rigid substances. And comes to intermolecules force of attraction. The solids have very strong intermolecular force. Because of that reason, the molecules or particles are bonded strongly. See, you can observe here. There is no gap between one particle to another particle. It means that due to no gap between the particles, we can say that the molecules have very strong force of attraction. Because of that reason, they are rigid. They have a one fixed shape, isn't it? Then they are compressed into very less amount. Got it, children? Next, we'll discuss about liquids. In the liquids, the molecules have space, children. In the liquids, what happens? They have a space from one particle to another particle here. Isn't it? You can look at here. We can find some spaces between one molecule to another molecule. So because of this reason, we can say that the liquids do not have a one particular shape. That is called, they do not have a one definite shape. They will take the shape of the container in which they catch. But they have a fixed volume, and due to the liquids taking, that is changing their shape, we can call them as a fluids. Means liquids will flow easily. For example, water, oil, juice, kerosene, these are all what? Flowing. This can be called as a liquid, children, here. Isn't it? The first point, what it says, they do not have a one fixed shape, but they take the shape of the container in which they kept, and even what they have a fixed volume here. And the second point says they are not rigid. It's very difficult to obtain its original shape. First of all, they don't have a shape. Where comes the matter of a rigid here? Isn't it? The liquids don't have a rigid. Then comes to there is intermolecular force. We can find compared to solids, they are the molecules are loosely packed. isn't it? The molecules are loosely packed in case of a liquid. And solids and liquids can be diffused into liquids. Even the gases, children, that is the gas from the atmosphere, that is nothing but the air from the atmosphere, diffuses the water and dissolves in the water. The understanding? Yeah. With a long point. Solids, liquids and gases can be diffused. Compared to solids, liquids can be diffused at a higher level. This is because due to the movement of free particles in the state. Liquid particles starts moving freely in the container. So, compared to solids, liquids can be diffused at a higher level. Got it? What are all the points we learn from the liquids, children? They do not have a one definite shape, but they have a fixed volume. They do not rigid. They are not rigid, isn't it? Compared to solids, their compressibility is little bit higher. The intermolecular force of attraction is less compared to solid. Then comes one gaseous. Gases do not have a one particular shape, children. That is called as a neither have a definite shape nor volume. They don't have both. Shape also don't have for them. Volume also not there for them. That is what here. Neither definite shape nor fixed volume we call. And they are not rigid. But the gases can be highly compressible. Because of this, we can compress gases into a wider range, children. For example, there is LPG. LPG is nothing but a liquefied petroleum gas which we use at our homes for cooking purposes. Similarly, there is CNG, that is compressed natural gas. It is used as a fuel in nowadays, isn't it? That is CNG acts like a main fuel in the recent days. And even the gases can be compressed into small cylinder and they can supply oxygen, isn't it? They can supply oxygen, which we can use at our hospitals in the form of oxygen cylinders. Because of which property? Because of highly compressible property, isn't it? Because the gases can be compressed into higher level compared to solids and liquids. And it have a wide application. Then what happens to the molecules arrangement? They are totally freely packed, children. See, you can find too much gap between one molecule to another molecule. This is called, they are loosely packed. Means the particles are moving freely. One more example I want to take, children. That is, the hot food smell can be felt even for a longer distance, isn't it? The smell of hot food reaches us very fast. Why? Because the particles of gases are moving very fastly and they possess more kinetic energy and they reaches us. Because of that reason, the gases can be what? They possess more kinetic energy than intermolecular force of attraction is very less in case of gases. But they can be compressed into higher amount compared to solids and liquids. Okay, now we will revise all the properties of solids, liquids and gases. Solids have a definite shape and they have a distinct boundaries and they have a fixed volume. And they all rigid. Intermolecular force of attraction between them is too much, isn't it? But they are less compressible. Whereas liquids, they do not have a one definite shape, but they can have a fixed volume. Compared to solids, solids can be compressed little bit higher. And the intermolecular force of attraction is little bit less. The molecules are freely, compared to solid, freely packed here. Then the third one, gases, they neither have a definite shape nor definite volume. And they have a what? Highly compressible property. Because of it, we have a wider application.